That's how
so much of this you don't know. You pretend that you know, but you don't know, and you bully people who ask you questions.
I really have to disagree with you. I spent a lot of time with this topic.
I'm open-minded. You are not.
Mr. Carlson, what happened to you, man? You used to be affable. You used to be friendly. You used to wear a nice tie. Now you wear one of those bibs and I don't know. So I don't know what happened to you, man, but I want you to consider that from the scientific perspective, pick the number you like, 97% of the world scientists, very close to 100% of the world scientists, are very concerned about climate change. And so why aren't some people concerned about it when media outlets were allowed to be consolidated in the 1980s? Then it developed these two factions like that I don't remember it having. By that, I think two factions are a normal course of events where you have males and females, your boys and girls, whether it's fruit flies or dandelions or you and me. And in the World Cup soccer, you end up with two teams. The World Series baseball, you end up with two teams. It's really hard to have three teams. And so I think, and we two political parties nominally. So somebody who understands this better than I do may observe that the media have divided into two camps. But from our point of view in the science and engineering side, you got to respect the facts at some level. You got to respect the what is scientifically provable. And then, speaking of authorities and mistrust of authorities, the crowd on at the inauguration, that was objectively smaller crowd than the crowd the next day at the Women's March. So when you, if someone asserts that the crowd is bigger when it was clearly smaller, then everything else he or she says is subject to question. And this has led to a lot of trouble. So I think, though, that built into the U.S. government, which includes the First Amendment of the Bill of Rights, the freedom of the press, built in is change. So I'm very hopeful, I'm optimistic, that things will change, that my understanding is subscriptions to so-called mainstream media, Washington Post, New York Times, and so on, have gone up in response to these to this approach to objective truths. So that will probably be to the good. But how fast will it happen, and what will go wrong in the meantime? These are big questions. And then as far as my thing with Mr. Carlson, I don't know. He used to not interview that way. He used to not just talk
exactly
the whole time.
Right. So at what point would it have changed? And I'm just saying, you don't actually know because it's unknowable.
So why aren't you open to questions? This is how long it takes you to interrupt me, okay? It takes you quite a bit less than 6 seconds.
I go back again in a second, Mr. Carlson. If you have me on again, I'll come right back on. Bring it on, man. And you know what else, Mr. Carlson? I'll bet you $10,000. That 2010-2020 will be the hottest decade on record. I offered a bet of $10,000 to Joe Bastardi, who is a Fox News contributor, and Mark Morano, who I'm not sure is a contributor, but used to appear on your station routinely, your network routinely. I bet them each $10,000. 2010-2020 will be the hottest decade on record. I bet them each another $10,000 on the decade, $10,000 on the year 2016. 2016 would have been among the top 10 hottest years on record. Wait, there's more. 2016 was the hottest year on record. And your guys, the people that Fox News heretofore supports in this, would not take either bet. $40,000. Wouldn't take the bet. Could have been theirs. I'm good for it.